Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here in Egypt, the center of the Asian world, to give some of our experience in breast augmentation. For 40 years, we are using some muscular implants under local anesthesia. We come from a poor country. We need to reduce the cost. We do ambulatory surgeries. We work with my partner, Diego Chavelson, in Buenos Aires. You are invited to visit us at any time. And the idea was to change the inferior periareolar approach to the lateral periareolar approach. I will show you step to step the procedure. The demarcation is very important with the arm elevated to observe the asymmetries. We start in 2012 the lateral approach. We disinfect the patient in a standing position. We put the patient on the sterile paper and in a cross position, IV way in any patient, single shot antibiotic 30 minutes before start the procedure. We use our peristaltic pump to infiltrate the tumescent solution. This is the solution we use, 1 liter with 1,200 milligram of lidocaine, 2 milliliter of adrenaline, and the last 4 years we add 500 milligram of tranexamic acid to the tumescent solution to reduce the risk of re-bleeding, because the adrenaline reduces the risk of bleeding, but the re-bleeding after the dissolution of the COG is stopped by tranexamic acid. We have the remote control in our hands for our pump, and we start the infiltration in the posterior border of pectoralis in the axilla with small incision, special cannula of 3.5 millimeters, very strong to elevate the muscle and allow us to go in a fan motion all around of the breast to infiltrate regularly 400 milliliters below each pectoral. This allows us to create the space for the implant. You can see the, and to avoid the exit of the solution because it's under pressure below the pectoralis, we close just with the needle. The idea is to produce a pocket below the pectoralis, the anterior serratus and the rectus abdominal. And we do this another infiltration with the rest of the solution in the approach, in the lateral area, and in the skin and glandular tissue, and reinforce in the lower border of the pocket. Why we change from this inferior periareolar? Because the inferior periareolar is crossing the forces of the gravitational forces and the contraction of the pectoralis. And sometimes you will have this type of contraction or retraction of the inferior periareolar. But the lateral periareolar is exactly in the same line of the gravity and on the contraction of the muscle. We start with the incision on the skin, just skin and dermis, and after a blunt dissection, trying to avoid the damage in the glandular tissue to reduce the possibility of contamination, because the glandular tissue is not sterile. There are natural germs inside of the breast tissue, and just in a radial action, we try to go between the asinus, trying to avoid the damage in the asinus. With the, this type of blunt maneuver, we arrive to the pectoralis muscle aponeurosis, and we open the aponeurosis in the same direction of the fibers, trying to go deep in the submuscular plane that is just dissected by the tumescent solution in the area. With the finger, we do all the pocket in just 1 minute, and the only non-expansible area is the fascia of the pectoralis, and we cut the fascia, the aponeurosis, with the cautery. We put some piece of gauze, and we go to the other side. When we return to this side, we remove the gauze and there is not bleeding in the area at all. We regularly check the pocket, and not necessary to use the cautery in 90% of the cases. We recheck the pocket, and this is the maneuver to dilate the entrance. We put two fingers. We know that if we can introduce two fingers in the tunnel, it's possible to introduce 400 cc of silicone implant. No traumatic dissection, no cutting, and you can use a gynecological instrument to dilate the area and to check inside. The implants need to be opened on the table, but before you need to inject some saline solution or tumescent solution to reduce the triboelectric forces, the magnetic forces that attract the powder or the tyndall in the operating room. Regularly, we introduce 3 mL of 5-fluorouracil inside of the capsule of the pocket to reduce the capsular formation. 5-fluorouracil is well known as antifibrotic, anti-keloid, and is excellent to reduce the possibility of capsula. Just 150 milligrams is enough to introduce. Now we open the implant, we disinfect the skin again with alcohol that is very effective and short time disinfection effect. And with the Keller funnel or with the hands, we can introduce the smooth surface implant. We use smooth surface for 40 years now with very low amount of capsular contraction in the pectoral pocket. We do the revision of the implant pocket, and finally we close the muscle. You can use the total submuscular or dual plane in this place, and to the closure of the muscle we use a special needle, the Bicryl, very strong. You can work in a safety way. We use this protection for the implant and for our coronary arteries that protect the implant to avoid the damage of the implant during the suture process. And finally, we close totally the muscle. We finish closing the glandular tissue, and finally, we close the dermis, and including the muscle of the areola, because if you don't suture the subareolar muscle, you will have irregular contraction in the future. Finally, the garment in place. Some cases before and after, you can see the an appreciable scar in the lateral area, different patient, different size, during the contraction, not movement of the implant, not a contraction of the scar, because the position is exactly in the same way of the contraction of the muscle. These are different sizes. Regularly in Argentina, and the medium size is 350. No, we don't are the American ones that like 1,000 or more. The scar in this area is very, very good quality regularly. The patient satisfaction rate is very high, and the cost of the procedure, because it's doing under local anesthesia and in ambulatory basis, is very low. You can see all the procedure in my YouTube channel, the video, and thank you very much for your attention.